I've actually like exchanged numbers with other celebrities, and they're always like, they'll like put it into something else, like SR, and I'm just like, Justin Timberlake.
It's embarrassing being a mess in front of you. Will's a much bigger mess than I am.
Huge congrats on Platonic. I've got to be honest, I fell in love with Gandalf the Lizard.
You so can did probably, Seth. Yeah, you can probably have him if you want.
Seth definitely bonded with him.
I didn't like him. I was at peace with Gandalf the Lizard.
He was at peace. He handled it. I found him. I got a little anxious.
I was afraid I was going to get some weird lizard disease. I don't know. I didn't grow up. I don't know what lizards will give you. I'm not from a lizardy place.
And they also can change their like gender fluid. Remember they were explaining that to us? A lot of interesting qualities they have that you wouldn't know.
I was afraid I was going to get salmonella from it, though. I didn't know.
I remember a lot of Purell.
A lot of Purell flying around in the lizard days. Yeah.
I will happily adopt him.
Yeah.
What are you up to?
Oh, why is this my life?
So, lunch?
No.
Brunch?
No. I don't have time for this.
Can't be friends with a girl.
There's lots of famous men and women friends. Laura Dern and Sam Neill in Jurassic Park.
You guys are just the dream duo. What are your favorite movies of each other's? Because you've both been in some of my absolute faves.
Aww. Wow.
Bridesmaids, I really love.
I loved The Fablemans.
Sunshine, right?
Wonderful.
The Danny Boyle one. That one's called Sunshine, right?
Yeah, that's such a deep cut.
It's a great movie.
Take this waltz. I like all the Lexan dramas.
I watched all of Damages, every episode. I'm a Damages completist.
I promise you, I won't miss.
I even followed it to like the Dish Network or whatever.
Lauren, so cute.
Great taste. What are some of the most common lines you both get though from your movies?
People don't come up to me that much anymore. I don't know what it is. Maybe I just don't leave the house as much as I used to.
I don't get quoted. I get more just, you know, depends on the demographic. But if it's a young girl, it's usually, bridesmaids, you know, which is always cute.
I get a lot of Pineapple Express is probably still the movie that people like.
Oh my God. Yeah. But that's the thing with Seth. There's a lot of content. I'm like, what do I choose? That movie's
this is what I mean. You're both the dream duo. There's so many projects. I adore Sylvia and Will's friendship. Out of all of the amazing characters that you've played, who would you like to be best friends with?
Will, on the guy on this show does not seem that good. The Fableman's character seems pretty nice. He might steal your wife, though.
Be careful. Yeah.
Snatch your wife.
I feel like the characters from Neighbors were pretty fun.
Yeah, the Neighbors, they seem like good people to be
friends
with.
They were actually a pretty good hang.
Yeah, they
seem
fun.
If you wanted to party.
Yeah, I'd go with the Neighbors people.
Yeah, they were a fun time.
We've got to be cool.
And we say, by the way, keep it down.
Well, we won't say it like that. Just like, keep it down.
What are you doing with this?
Keep it down.
Just don't, we've overworked it.
Sylvia and Will know how to have a good night out. Who's a friend in the industry that you can always rely on to have a good time with? Who's that party person for you guys?
Who's a good party person?
I don't know them. If they're out there, they're not calling me necessarily.
I think they're calling me.
Yeah. I don't know. We're high up there.
There's a lot of people I think look like a good party
person. Yeah, they seem like they're having a good
time. I wish I could go out with them.
People I look at, they're like, they seem like they're having a good time. Yeah.
You know,
the
Rihanna,
weekend. Yeah,
you know,
Rihanna, they seem like they're
incredible.
Really living it up.
Yeah. So you're saying that you need a night out with the weekend then?
I mean,
absolutely.
Yes, if I'm up for it, yeah.
You still got that family of yours?
You want to see a photo?
Wow, there they are. Cool.
This series is obviously all about friends reconnecting, and it's such a treat to see you guys reunite. Were there any changes that you noticed about each other this time round?
I just think you're just older, right?
Yeah,
you're
like
a little more.
I think we're just both more tired than we were the first
time
we were together.
More set in your ways of what you like and don't like as well. Like, you know, but in the Neighbors movies, we're playing a married couple, so there's an innate like affection and empathy, and you really
like a kindness,
are
yeah,
kindness. But, and in this, it's like way more like you could
the
be.
The gloves felt off.
Yeah, the gloves were off, and it was. And I remember halfway or early on, we were like, it's a little bit different, isn't it?
Yeah, like we were improvising and like, oh, we're being much meaner to one another than we would be in these other things
the
we've
other
done
things,
together. Yeah.
And that was
probably
fun.
Funny though.
Probably,
yeah.
Hopefully funnier.
Oh, geez.
This is how a woman experiences a midlife crisis.
Like a couple of teenage girls. Your whole thing is so weird and destructive.
I love how Sylvia has Will saved on her phone as asshole. Do you guys have any creative names for people on your phones?
So many.
Oh, I do.
So please
many.
List them off.
Yeah.
I can't even, like, it's like what I know them from, like,
Me too. Yeah. I'm like, you know,
Jeff from Undeclared.
That's what I got. Susie, mum, Susie, mum, Court Street, Brooklyn, met her last week.
Yeah.
There'll
be little paragraphs explaining who the person is.
There's so many people come and go, and you're like, I get
a lot of that.
I'm not ashamed to do that.
Do you have any creative names for each other, though?
Rose Byrne. I also, if anyone steals my phone, they'll have access to a lot of like uncoded celebrity phone numbers. It's like, no, I haven't even thought. I've actually exchanged numbers with other celebrities, and they're always like, they'll like put it into something else, like SR, and I'm just like Justin Timberlake.
The thing with I feel like they're always changing their numbers.
Yeah, that's true.
That's the other thing. It's like, wait, what? Who's this? And it's like,
I used to get a text from like Zac Efron every like 6 months that he had a new phone.
Yeah. It's the same with like, you know, Pete Davidson with Bobby. Yeah. So he's like, bro, why have we got a new number?
New number. Yeah, what are you doing? I've literally had the same phone number since the 90s.
Are you a 323?
Yeah.
I'm a 917. Now we're really getting granular. But, me too.
I was part of one of the great biggest hacking scandals in the history of humanity. I still didn't change my phone number.
Double down.
Exactly.
Same number.
Keep it.
I'm just imagining someone having a field day with your phone, Seth, now.
Yeah, exactly.
They would. That's huge data in there.
But this series is so much fun. What was a real highlight for you guys making this?
We had a fun cast, you know, like really fun people. I like the days when everybody was there. Like some of the bigger set pieces were really funny. With it, like Secret Skills was really funny. Yeah. And
shooting in that fake bar was fun, and it started to feel like a real bar that we were all hanging out in all the time. And it was just nice. It was like a great group of people that all got along very well, and it was like fun coming to work every day. And I think especially when you're making a comedy where you're improvising a lot and like kind of putting yourself out there and taking big swings, it's like a great environment to do that kind
of thing. Yes, Nick definitely creates that. Yeah.
Well, it's so much fun. You've both done an amazing job with it. Thank you so much for talking to me. And also thank you for reminding me to try and find my high necklace. This reminded me that I need to look for it after.
Oh, good. You'll find it. I'm welcome. You're welcome.
Get it.